Welcome to the statics tutorials. So for this problem, we need to solve for the reactions. We have a smooth, frictionless rod here, and then a collar at A, and then the beam is attached with a fixed support to the collar, and then we have the beam resting on a smooth, frictionless surface over here on B. And we've got just a real assortment of loadings on the beam. So we have a 12 pound force going down, we have a 10 pound per foot distributed load here, and then on the end we have a 75 pound foot clockwise moment. So drawing the free body diagram, because this can slide up and down on the beam, there's no Y component to the reaction, but this would resist both translation in the X, so we have a normal force here going in the X direction, and then also rotation around point A. So we have a moment at A. Here's our 12-pound force going down, our 10-pound per foot distributed load, our 75-pound foot couple moment. And then at B here, where we contact the smooth, frictionless surface, we're going to wind up with a normal force. So if this incline is 40 degrees to the x-axis, then our normal force is going to be 40 degrees to our y-axis. So here's our sum of forces in the x equation. So we have NA, and then the only other force that has an x component is this NB. So we're going to use NB sine of 40 degrees. The NB is going in the negative direction. So we get NA is equal to 0.6428 NB. And then we can do our sum of forces in the y direction. So we've got our negative 12 pounds there. We've got our distributed load, rectangular shape distributed load. So we have 10 pound per foot times the base of 5.5 feet. And then we have the Y component of the force NB, so NB cosine of 40. That one's positive, our distributed load is negative. That allows us to solve for NB and get the 22.2 pounds. Plug that back in up here for NA and get that NA is 14.3 pounds. Then we just need to do our sum of the moments about A so that we can solve for that reaction moment at A. So we have our MA, we drew it in the positive or counterclockwise direction, so it has a positive contribution. And then we have our 12 pound times our 0.75 feet that it's from A, and that's going to be a negative contribution here to the moment. Then we have our NB cosine of 40 at the end, and that's all the way at the 1.75 feet, and that's going to be a positive contribution to our moment. Here's our distributed load, and again, remember with distributed loads, you have to calculate the force first. So this is a rectangular distributed load, so just like we calculated sum of forces in the Y, just our distributed load times our 0.5 feet that it acts over, and that's just the force portion. Then we need to multiply that by our distance. So we're going to go all the way up to the end, 1.75, and then come over half of the 0.5 back from the end. So 1.75 minus 0.5 divided by 2. That distributed load gives us a negative contribution to the moment. And then we have, this is just continuing this line down, we have a negative 75 pound foot clockwise moment, and that's equal to 0. And that allows us to solve for our MA, and it's 61.8 pound foot, and it's positive, so that means that it is clockwise. Thanks for watching.